Gordon Mogata, Concordia, Taoiseach Sinn Féin's view also was that there needs to be a fully independent inquiry into Savita's death, and that this has to have both the confidence of the Irish public and international opinion, but most particularly the confidence and cooperation and trust of Savita's husband, Praveen, and her family. And that does require, at whatever level it is conducted, that's a matter for the government, but it does require prior consultation with the family, and particularly with Praveen, because otherwise what may be a good move, with all due deference to the people from Galway University Hospital, you're only second-guessing the family unless you can get their prior agreement on this. So could I ask, is this the first the family are going to hear about this when they listen to the media reports? And would it not be far better that there was appropriate consultation with them so that they would know what the government's position is? And, you know, and all of this, because the issues are so faxed and so difficult for the family, we need to be trying to get consensus on how we proceed. So could I ask you, leaving aside your assertion that you didn't have consultation and the Minister of Health didn't have consultation, is there some other form of contact with the family?
Thank you.
Deputy, I agree that this is an issue that needs to be determined in as speedily and as efficiently and as sensitively as possible to find out the facts and the truth of what actually happened here, where Savita Halappanavar died. Now, as I understand this, the HSE have been and are in contact through lawyers for her husband, acting for her husband, and I understand that the chairman is seeking a meeting with the Praveen Halappanavar himself. I hope, in the context of cooperation and understanding, taking into account the sensitivities of the family arising from the loss of Savita, that this the understanding of the independence of this investigation can happen, because it is very necessary for everybody here that the truth and the facts be determined. I've listened to a range of comments. I've read quite a number of statements that have been issued from Ireland and abroad, which to determine as facts matters that we do not know with absolute truth, whether they're factual or not. That's a matter as to what the investigation would actually determine. I would hope that Praveen Halappanavar would cooperate with the changed investigation team, which will be entirely independent. And I think it's very important that that his cooperation would be forthcoming. So in that sense, the immediacy here is to determine what happened and determine that accurately and truthfully, and that the Minister for Health be able to deal with that in the context of giving understanding and comfort and making women who are about to give birth or go to hospital to give birth, that they have an understanding of the very highest standards that operate in Irish maternity hospitals. So I do hope that the connections that are being made between the HSE and the lawyers for Praveen Halappanavar and the wish of the chairman to speak to him directly will result in cooperation of the family here being made available for this investigation, which will now be entirely independent.
Deputy Adams.
And I understand this is a hugely difficult issue to deal with, and I agree with you that we have to wait for the facts to emerge about how precisely Savita died and the circumstances of that, and I'm distinguishing between that and the failure of the Oireachtas to give legal protection to women who are pregnant, and also to give legal clarity to our medical practitioners. I'm drawing a distinction between the two. And we know in a different context where families have campaigned that unless you get the families to have ownership of the process, and unless the families are treated in a way which allows them to almost own the process and to have confidence and trust in it, then we end up exacerbating the situation. So I deduct from your answer that the family may not have been consulted, and I shouldn't have to tease this out like this, Taoiseach. I just think it's of huge importance that they know prior to it being publicly announced what's going on. And, you know, this unfortunate woman died in the care of one of our hospitals in the end of October, and here we are on the 20th of November. 2 weeks passed without any news about this tragic situation at all. And then the government seems to be sort of playing catch-up in the process of what should be, in this day and age, a natural consequence, because we do have a very high standard, but a natural consequence of public disquiet, that there should be a fully independent public inquiry, and I state again that has the confidence, trust of the family. So could I ask again, Taoiseach, just very directly, and I have a two-pronged question. One, have the family been given prior notice of what has just been announced? And two, if not, could they be seen as a matter of urgency by whoever is appropriate to give them some sense of what the government's plans are, and also to give them the opportunity to tell the government how they wish to proceed?
Thank you.
Well, my understanding, Deputy Adams, is that before I came in here, the HSE informed the lawyers for Mr. Halapanavar of this change of personnel to be appointed to the investigation team. I also understand that the chairman, Mr. Arul Kumran, is seeking a meeting personally with the husband of Savita, that is Praveen Halapanavar. As I said to you, we have a duty, and the minister has a responsibility to proceed with the investigation to find out what happened in the circumstances in which Savita Halapanavar died. That's an imperative, and I would hope that her husband would give cooperation to the investigation to be now comprised of utterly independent people from University College Hospital Galway. I think that's very necessary, and the investigation has to proceed to determine those facts and the accuracy of those facts and the truth of what happened in everybody's interest. So the HSE informed the lawyers for Mr. Halapanavar before he came in here of this change, the chairman seeking a meeting with her husband, and I hope that out of that can come a consensus from the families, from the family's perspective, and taking into account their trauma and his grief, that it's in everybody's interest that we find out what exactly happened here. And from that point of view, I do hope that he can give his cooperation, because this investigation has to find out what happened there in the interests of the people of the country generally, of the public, but particularly of women who go to hospital to give birth, that they know that they are in a safe environment where the highest standards apply. And you are aware of the statistics over the years. So it's an unfortunate tragedy. A man's wife has died. Nothing will bring her back. But it is important for our country, for our people, the family, for everybody concerned to ascertain the truth of what happened here, and this investigation can hopefully do that with the cooperation of Mr. Halapanavar speedily and efficiently, as the chairman pointed out, and he is a person who knows what he's talking about, who's conducted investigations previously, and has an international reputation of the highest integrity.
Thank you. Deputy Pringle.